Salesian Missionaries of Mary Immaculate. SMMI, sent on a special mission for women and the poor. Every SMMI across the world is driven by one common goal: to spread love through service. Unfolding the glorious past of contributions and impacts that last. The congenial inspirations of Father Henry Chamor and Madame Caroline Carrie de Malberg sprang into a society of the Daughters of St. Francis de Sales, on the 15th of October in the year 1872 in France. The founder motivated the members with two aims: personal holiness and apostolate in the spirit of St. Francis de Sales. The members lived an exemplary life with utmost dedication as well as simplicity in their lifestyle, which inspired many others. Very soon, this tiny society grew into a giant tree with many branches. Catechist Missionaries of Mary Immaculate, as a missionary branch of the society, ventured into far-off countries with a zeal kindled out of love for God and His people. The Catechist Missionaries of Mary Immaculate, CMMI, from 1889 have spread across 19 countries with a unique charism to the most vulnerable sections of society. In response to an invitation by the Diocese of Nagpur to support the Church with its dynamic mission, the CMMI landed on Indian soil on the 2nd of November 1889, and the pioneers were Mother Marie Gertrude of the Precious Blood, Sister Magdalene of the Blessed Sacrament, Sister Joseph of the Visitation, and Sister Marie de Costica. Selfless and committed service rendered by the pioneers to women, orphans, lepers, the homeless, elderly and deceased under the stewardship of Mother Marie Gertrude in Nagpur and at Kumbakonam opened wide the horizons in different parts of India and abroad. In 1968, the Catechist Missionaries of Mary Immaculate was juristically established as a religious congregation known as the Salesian Missionaries of Mary Immaculate, which has developed into 5 provinces and 2 regions in India: Nagpur, Thanjavur, Karnataka, Raipur, Salem, Kerala and Northeast are the established centers in India where the SMMI work actively with their unique charism for women and the poor. The Bishop of Bangalore, Monsignor Augustine Francois Basil, impressed by the challenging service of the SMMI sisters to the lepers in Kumbakonam, invited them to Bangalore. The pioneers, Mother Anastasi and Sister Felix, accompanied by Mother Jane de Gethsemane, arrived in Bangalore on the 10th of July 1914 and was officially established on the 12th of July 1914. Father Peter M. Briand, the then parish priest of St. Joseph's Church, facilitated the sisters to establish a school as well as a hospital and be engaged in educational and healthcare ministries to the slum dwellers in the surrounding area. Every drop makes an ocean. This humble beginning with simplicity and authenticity for the poor and the less privileged of society has resulted in establishing 23 missions over a period of 100 years. Today, after a century, that is 1914 to 2014, 228 sisters work in 7 dioceses of Karnataka, Kurnool Diocese of Andhra Pradesh and the Diocese of Suniyani at Ghana, West Africa. Salesian Missionaries of Mary Immaculate, Karnataka Province, Bangalore Mission, 100 years. The Bangalore Mission credits its splendid success to the dedicated service of the sisters for the past 100 years. The lifestyle of the sisters. The sisters receive intense spiritual formation and professional training. The sisters draw their strength from the daily spiritual exercises and integrate it in their apostolate. Community living is the source of strength for sisters to work as a team. Experiencing God in one's life and Mary Immaculate as the guiding star, the sisters set out cheerfully to share God's unconditional love through diverse activities.
Community life of every Smmi is centered at the heart of Jesus, and we live a life of simplicity in Salesian spirit. We acknowledge that it is God who brings us together to live a life of love and for a common mission to serve the women and the poor. The exemplified missionary life lived by our pioneers is a source of inspiration even today after 100 years to carry out the mission with much enthusiasm.
Pastoral, educational, medical and social services are the main streams of apostolate. Pastoral Ministry. Salesian Missionaries of Mary Immaculate, originally known as Catechist Missionaries, mainly involved themselves in Christian faith formation. Preparing children and the faithful for sacraments, forming active groups in parishes like Legion of Mary, altar servers, youth associations, adult associations, marriage counseling, vocation camps, visiting and counseling the families as well as the sick, offering shelter to the homeless, and forming the Association of the Daughters of St. Francis de Sales are the various activities programmed to be vibrant in carrying out the core principles of Catechist Missionaries. Evangelization through art and music, an effective means. The congregation highly appreciates the unique contributions of Sister Claire and the late Sister Genevieve to the Universal Church. Biblical paintings of Sister Claire and late Sister Genevieve are instrumental in communicating the true knowledge of God's love for humanity. Inspired by the Indian Christian art of Sister Claire, Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI proclaimed her the artist of the church. He even encouraged people to pray through her depictions of the stations during the Way of the Cross conducted in the Vatican on Good Friday in 2009. Sister Claire, being the pioneer in Indian Christian art, is the first recipient of the Assisi Award for her lifetime achievement in art by the Office for Social Communications of CBCI and Art India Forum to nurture the divine in art.
God is the creator. God is the divine artist. Artwork is God's work. Every artist continues the creation of God. My art is inherited from my family, especially from my mother, a Hindu origin. You feel in my art meditative, contemplative and inspirational moods. All the religions feel at home with my art. My apostolate is to proclaim Christ to the world through my art.
Our late Sister Mary Celine was the pioneer in composing and singing Christian hymns in the local language, Kannada. Her contributions have been tremendous in the growth of the local church in Karnataka. Educational Ministry. Education plays an important role in shaping the future of our country. However, 69% of our country's population comes from rural background where education is a privilege. The SMMI is contributing its mite to establish and develop schools so as to provide quality and value-based education in rural and slum areas. Mother Marie Gertrude, the co-foundress of the missions in India, a great visionary, deeply convinced that the education of the girl child would in turn educate and enlighten the entire family, courageously took up the challenge of teaching in Marathi medium. Imbibing the spirit of Mother Marie Gertrude, the SMMI concentrates on holistic development of every girl child under its care. The schools strive to give the much needed support to young girls to pursue their career goals. Sponsorships, scholarships, free boarding facilities, remedial classes, moral and social trainings, counseling and health-related programs are some of the initiatives to fulfill their aim.
ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಅಮೃತ. ನಾನೀಗ ಬಿ ಕಾಂ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಬಂದಿರೋದು ಎಲ್ಲ SMMI ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಅವ್ರ ಫುಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂದಾನೇ ನಾನು ಬಂದಿರೋದು. ನನ್ನೊಬ್ಬಳಿಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನನ್ನ ಥರ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಮಂದಿ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಓದೋಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇನ್ನೂ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ನಾನು ಅವ್ರ ಕೈ ಜೋಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಸುಪ್ರೀತಾ, ನಾನು ನರ್ಸರಿಯಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಎಸ್ಎಂಎಂಐ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನರ್ಸರಿಯಿಂದ ಟಿಲ್ 10th ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ತನಕ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದು ಹಾಸ್ಟೆಲ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೀಸು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ವಸತಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಬೆಳೆಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. 10th ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡಲ್ಲೂ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ನಾನು PUCಗೆ ಹೋದೆ. PUC ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ಇವರೇ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋ, ಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ನಾನು ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಈವನ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲೂ ನಾನು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡೆ. ಈಗ ನಾನು CA ಸ್ಟಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೂ ಇವರೇ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾನು ಬೆಳೆದಿರೋದು ಮತ್ತು ಈಗ ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದು CA ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದೆಲ್ಲ ಇವ್ರ ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂದಾನೆ. ಸೊ SMMI ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಮನಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ಕೃತಜ್ಞತೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತೀನಿ.
Our educational institutions comprise of 13 schools and 5 diocesan schools under our care. Pre-university college, day as well as evening degree college and D.Ed. college are established at St. Mary's Convent, Chamrajpet to facilitate women for higher education. The Tumkur unit has challengingly started a CBSE school up to class 12, offering a unique educational opportunity for the poor. The school strives to bring to light the talents in every poor child. Academic excellence is nurtured among the students in a serene school atmosphere. Effective teaching by well-qualified staff and good infrastructure. Our educational institutions aim at providing a strong foundation for a disciplined life involving different activities like life skills programs, mock parliaments, girl guiding, bulbuls and NSS, cultural competitions, educational tours, etc., which unite the home, school and society to build up the young to be healthy and responsible citizens of the future. The school helps students to grow into ideal citizens as they learn how to take up leadership and responsible decisions, as well as communicating effectively to create an atmosphere of peace in their milieu. In today's competitive digital world, basic computer skills are a prerequisite for most career options, something that the rural youth find difficult to acquire at an affordable price. The SMMI institutions make the necessary investments to make possible the e-revolution in the rural areas.
Educational ministry is one of the powerful means of apostolate to reach out to the people with the good news of Christ. Our schools have been instrumental in catering to the most vulnerable section of the society, especially in rural areas. Thousands of children have successfully passed out of our institutions with flying colors. In line with the charism of the congregation, our educational institutions concentrate towards the upliftment of every girl child and strives hard to bring them to the mainstream of the society by providing quality education.
SMMI dreams ahead to make the dreams of every child come true. Health Ministry. The Institute provides quality health care with concessions to those who can afford their only precious little. Enterprising former missionaries left out no village in their missions while reaching out to the sick through the mobile clinics. Right from the beginning, SMMI embraced this noble cause of healthcare and have come a long way in serving the poor with quality maternity and childcare, as well as free medical camps in rural areas. In the past, when TB was the main killer, thousands of tuberculosis patients were treated successfully in St. Teresa's Sanatorium, Rajajinagar. With the use of new modern medical technology, the multi-facility hospitals at Ranjajinagar, Chamrajpet, Bangalore, Chamrajnagar, Mysore and Pandavapura are effectively serving numerous poor patients.
Our hospitals and healthcare centers were mainly established for the welfare of the women and the poor. The people have witnessed not only the human touch and medical aid for their speedy recovery, but the divine touch of sympathy, love, care and concern at our centers. Maternity homes in rural areas all over the state have successfully ensured the safe deliveries and intensive care of the babies. Free camps and mobile clinics have been the initiatives of the institute for the benefit of the poor and the women.
De-addiction and psychiatric center at Mysore ceaselessly endeavors in treating drug addicts and rehabilitating them. This is a highly responsible response of the institute to modern society to facilitate the affected to rediscover a bright future. To reunite and to recreate smiles in every family. True to the spirit of the charism, the SMMI have initiated aid nursing training program for pre-matric school dropout girls and provides them free training, boarding, lodging and job placement facilities. Social Ministry. SMMI caters to the social needs of society under Jeevan Pragati Trust. The sisters work with the most sensitive population of society, the women sector, striving for overall development of every individual and focusing on developing vocational trainings to help employability. Tailoring, fashion designing, embroidery and computer knowledge are some of the skill-based trainings in different centers of the province to empower women.
Empowerment of women is one of the indispensable needs of the society till today. Right from the foundation, our congregation has focused on various issues concerning women welfare and development. Many projects undertaken to uplift the rural girls and women have been successful and fruitful. The girls and women feel free to approach us at any time and they are rendered with the best service possible.
Mobile Tailoring Centers is a creative and novel initiative of reaching out to women in rural areas with no proper transportation. Individual guidance and counseling have been the unique interest of the SMMI to help women in their personality development, mental stability and empowerment.
ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಸಿಚ್ಚನ ಅಂತ ನಾನು 4 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ನನಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಲರಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸೈನರ್ ಬ್ಲೌಸು ಮತ್ತು ಚೂಡಿದಾರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಲ್ತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಸ್ಟಿಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಲ್ದಿರ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಕೂಡ ಸ್ಟಿಚ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅರ್ನ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ
ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಜಾಬ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರರಿ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಎಮರ್ಜೆನ್ಸೀಸ್ and free medical treatment in sickness of the downtrodden women is the greatest concern of the SMMI. Home for the children. Child care, the most integral charism of the SMMI. We have 14 homes for orphan children and destitute girls, providing food, clothing, shelter, education and family care, their most felt need. The neglected and rural children enjoy ample space for growth and through education are encouraged to dream challenging careers and fulfilling lives.
Special care for the orphans has always been an effective apostolate in line with our charism. Earlier, many children had to be sheltered as they were left homeless in times of war, cholera, and natural disasters. We even had boarding for boys in Shetterly, where many boys were educated and settled. Among them, some joined seminary and are priests now. Children in our boardings are given opportunities to develop their talents. Utilizing the service of the sisters, many children have successfully completed their MBA, BBM, and their teacher's training and have shaped their bright future.
The sisters have wonderfully performed over the 100 years the noble task of educating, settling thousands of orphan girls in marriage, remarriage of widows and divorcees, and an ongoing care to lead a happy married life in their very own families.
ನಮಗೆ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಇವಾಗ ಈ ನಮಗೆ ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೊಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಚಿಕ್ಕ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನಿಂದ ಇದ್ದು ಮದುವೆ ಆಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಾದ್ರೂ ಅವ್ರು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಕಷ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಭಾಗಿಯಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರ ಕೆಲಸ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಕಾರ್ಯ ಇದ್ರು ನಮಗೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇದುವಾಗಾಯಿತು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೂ ಅವರು ಕೈ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೂ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೂ ಕಷ್ಟ ಸುಖ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ರೀತಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
An old saying goes, a man growing old becomes a child again. Sisters have extended the warmth of their hearts to provide the elderly a serene and restful place to retire and age gracefully old. Mercy Home at Rajaji Nagar and Asha Kirana at Chettihalli are committed in providing simple and peaceful living atmosphere to 36 senior citizens with good food, basic amenities and health care by the dedicated service of the sisters.
ನಮ್ಮ ತೀರೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ತಂದು ಕಾನ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಕೈ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. 3 ತಿಂಗಳು ಮಗುವಿಂದ ನಾನು ಇದೇ ಕಾನ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಇದೇ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹತ್ರ ನಾನು ಹೀಗೆ ಬೆಳೆದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಈಗ ನನಗೆ 71 ವರ್ಷ. ನಮ್ಮ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯಾವ ಕಾಯಿಲೆ ಬಂದರೂ ಸರಿನೇ, ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಸೌಕರ್ಯ ಇದೆ. ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು ಪ್ರೀತಿ, ಸಂತೋಷ, ಶಾಂತಿ, ಸಮಾಧಾನ, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
Experiencing the pressing need of spreading God's love to global frontiers, many of our sisters, as courageous missionaries, have stepped out to different countries in 5 continents to reach the good news worldwide. SMMI is grateful to all its benefactors, co-workers and friends who extend their support in fulfilling our noble charism of empowering women and the poor through various apostolates. The elderly sisters are cared with due respect and concern for their well-being. The congregation gratefully acknowledges the priceless lifetime service rendered by the sisters. Reverently bidding adieu at the end of their life, the sisters are laid to rest at Nirmalagiri, Kengeri.
St. Mary's Convent, Bangalore, the mother house of Karnataka province, celebrating 100 years of its foundation, led by the missionary spirit of our foundress, Mother Marie Gertrude. The 5 years I have lived up to the charism of the congregation to reach out to the women and the marginalized of the society. Thousands of orphan children have been cared, nurtured, and sheltered in this mission. Hundreds of girls have been freely educated, trained, settled in marriage to build a future. Many women have been empowered through skillful trainings. They are sheltered and supported in times of trials, sickness, and difficulties. Our maternity and child care services have supported to many women and children in need. Hundreds of broken families have been united and lit with faith through the pastoral ministries of the mission. On this occasion, I express my sincere respect and reverence to all the sisters who worked to make this glorious history of 100 years. And I also gladly compliment all my sisters for their wonderful service to this mission. I am grateful to all the benefactors for their generous contribution to support our various apostolate. I wish every SMMI the very best in all their services.
Every child matters. Every smile matters. Every dream matters. Every life matters. Every day, we continue to strive to bring a smile on every face, to enrich lives, and to build a better future for the world we live in.